Hey everyone, today we are making a Mexican pizza like Taco Bell, but vegan, of course. And Taco Bell did just re-release this fan favorite, and so I went ahead and paid them a visit, and this is what it looks like. And like, even with cheese and meat, this can't be what y'all were going bananas for, is it? I mean, I tried it, and yeah, it's good for fast food, but it also costs $5. You know, I'm not sure, but I'm guessing even with all the vegan meat and cheese on mine, that mine isn't more than $5, meaning mine is not only vegan and better, but bigger and cheaper. So let's make one at home. But before we do, it's worth noting that this recipe is for my new cookbook, Vegan Fast Food. Yes, in case you missed it, I have a new cookbook with a bunch of new recipes. In fact, there's a few Taco Bell recipes in there, like the Crunchwrap and the Cheesy Gordita Crunch, amongst many others. So if you think you might buy it, please check the link in the description and pre-order as soon as possible, as pre-orders really help with a book's reach. But for this recipe, there's a lot of shortcuts or different options. For instance, you can totally use some taco seasoning like this if you like, or if you like more flavor, you can get 3 tablespoons of chili powder. Make sure it's this kind of stuff, which is a seasoning blend, and then 1 tablespoon each of garlic powder, onion powder, cumin, smoked paprika, chipotle powder, oregano, and then 2 teaspoons of ground coriander, and optionally, but recommended, 1 teaspoon of citric acid for some zippiness. And then lastly, 1 teaspoon of salt. Mix that up, throw it in a seasoning shaker if you like, and there we go. Now for the red sauce we're about to make, you can totally just use some of this canned enchilada sauce, but just like with the taco seasoning, homemade is better. So melt up 2 tablespoons of vegan butter and then add in 2 tablespoons of flour to make a roux. Whisk that together and then cook off the raw flour taste for about a minute. Next, we'll whisk in 1 cup of veggie broth. And then once that's nice and smooth, we're gonna whisk in 8 ounces of tomato sauce and then get a jar of pickled jalapenos and get yourself 2 tablespoons of that brine and throw that in there. And then after that, we'll add one of my favorite ingredients of all time, these diced chipotles in adobo, which will add some spicy smokiness. So let's do 2 tablespoons of that, and then 1 tablespoon of lime juice, 2 tablespoons of the taco seasoning we just made, salt and pepper to taste if needed. And then we just need to simmer and reduce that for about 5 to 10 minutes or until we have something like a thick pizza sauce such as this. And I gotta say, this stuff is so good, I could eat it like a soup. I might have to try it on some vegan huevos rancheros next. And now onto the beef, and you can totally use something like these canned lentils if you don't wanna use plant-based beef like I am. But I'm gonna go ahead and break up 1 pound of said beef, let that brown over medium-high heat for a few minutes, and then we're gonna squeeze in 1 tablespoon of lime juice, 3 tablespoons of our taco seasoning, and then 1 cup of water. And if you're using something like lentils, I would use veggie stock instead of water and maybe season it a bit more, but either way, we'll let that reduce just for a minute or so, and that is basically our vegan ground beef. And for the beans, obviously, use a can of refried beans if you want to, but I'm going to do things a bit differently. I'm going to start off with 2 cans of whole pinto beans, and I'm going to use about half of the bean juice that they came in. I'm just going to mash them up like so, and that bean juice will help emulsify and make our beans a lot creamier than if we just drained and rinsed them. If you're scared of the bean juice and want to drain and wash them, just use about 1/2 cup of unsweetened plant milk to get them to the right consistency. And once they're all mashed up, we'll go ahead and season them by adding 3 tablespoons of the taco seasoning, 2 tablespoons of lime juice, 2 tablespoons of chipotles in adobo, salt and pepper to taste, and now you have some of the best beans you can make in less than 10 minutes. And for the cheese, you can totally use whatever vegan cheese you like and just throw it on the pizza like so. And this is the pizza I made with some Follow Your Heart vegan cheese. But for this one, I did my cheese hack where I melt down an 8-ounce bag of VeoLife shreds with 1/2 teaspoon of sodium citrate and 1/2 cup of water, and then I put them in these pink molds, freeze them, then let them partially thaw and shred them up like this. It's an extra step, but I find the texture of the cheese when melted is far better. I filmed the process, but I accidentally deleted the footage, so my apologies. Now last but not least is the tostada pizza crust. The original pizza is on the smaller side, so I'm using these giant soft taco tortillas instead, but you do whatever you like. Either way, to make them crunchy, we can bake or fry them. To bake them, simply add them to a baking sheet, spray them with some cooking spray, season with salt if you wanna, and then bake them at 400 degrees Fahrenheit for about 5 minutes, flip them, and then bake for another 5 minutes or until browned as desired. To fry them, it's quite simple. Fill up a deep skillet with about 1/2 inch of oil like peanut, vegetable, or canola. Bring that up to 350 degrees Fahrenheit and then just fry them up until beautifully golden brown. If they puff up, just push them down, show them who's boss, flip them as needed, and once they are beautiful, let them drain the oil, and rest on a wire rack. And now it's time to build our pizza. So start with your first tostada pizza crust, add a nice layer of the beans, and then another nice layer of the beef. Add your second pizza crust, and then a good old layer of that red sauce. Sprinkle on as much vegan cheese as you'd like, and then broil or use a kitchen torch to melt the cheese. Once it's melted, add some diced tomatoes. You can also use something like these if you wanna. Just make sure you drain them. And then add some chopped chives for a green thing. And now it's time to dig in. And I was so excited to dig in that I forgot to film myself cutting the pizza and eating the first slice. So that's why I have 3/4 of a pizza here. But I gotta say, this thing was heads and shoulders above the one I tried at Taco Bell. And I totally ate one at 7:30 in the morning just to make sure it was as fresh as possible. And still, this homemade version is on a whole other league. The tostada shells were way more crunchy and flaky, and everything else was just simply better. More seasoning, flavor, spice, everything you want in something like this. Also, you might have some leftovers, and that's a good thing. You can either make more Mexican pizzas, or you can make some of my other Taco Bell recipes. In fact, if you want to make some Taco Bell potatoes and some creamy jalapeno sauce, click right here for that video. If you do, let me know how it goes, and until then, I'll see you all next time.